Good evening, everybody. So today's day 6 of the Egglocke challenge, and the most recent event that we've had happen is our unfortunate loss of Old Timer. Old Timer fainted during the last gym battle, attempting to save Rockstar. Rockstar's still in our party, so it succeeded in that, but unfortunately it did faint. And we also hatched a Suntanner from an egg. Which reminds me, I do have even more eggs now, though I don't have anything to catch, anything to replace with at the moment. So we might do a light bit of training before we go off and try and beat the gym leader, just because we got two Pokemon that aren't even level 30 yet. Not to mention, I do actually want to head back to Hammerlock and buy some stuff. Buy some clothing. Because there is, I believe it's a TM that I get from somebody. But I need to be all fiery red. Besides, I'm actually curious how that's going to look on this character. First, let's switch into our fire uniform, just so that I have an idea of how this is going to go. Well, excuse me. That's actually an interesting look. Might keep some parts of that. Let's see here. Definitely by you. I actually like some of those skirts. Let's see here. Any other fires? Actually, I'm curious if there are any decent bags in here. I don't see any. But we'll grab the fire one. Alright, and what about a hat? Don't like those hats for her. I'm going to hope that's enough, because I don't want to change her glasses. At least not to sunglasses like my main character has. I like sunglasses on male characters. I don't have a fondness for them on females. Don't ask me why. I have different tastes. Hello there. Fwaga! Fwagagaga! I'm a Pokemon. Have a battle with me. Listen for a second. Scorbunny and Sizzlipede are different species, but they're still both Pokemon. Scorbunny and I are different species, just like Sizzlipede and I are different too. If you think about it that way, there's no problem with calling me a Pokemon. I don't mind. What? You don't have to worry about me. Even I know it's pretty lofty logic. I wanted to become a Pokemon once. You can be one. Hey, I've got it. A change of fashion style could change the way I feel, too. Basically, if I make myself feel the way a Pokemon does, it'd be like I became a Pokemon, don't you think? You, would you please put on some clothes with a fiery spirit that embodies my burning feelings? What's this? Is that? I feel like I've completely become a Pokemon. Wearing a hot, fire-styled outfit can make you feel different. I feel like I've become a fire-type Pokemon. Thanks for cheering me up. It's hardly a proper reward, but I hope you like it anyway. Acrobatics is a move that does more damage if the user isn't holding an item. Alright. That was definitely worth all the money I paid for it. Because now Luchador has probably the most powerful attack on this team now. Good Bye, Aerial Ace. I'm keeping Dig on this thing, just because of how useful it was versus the Ghost Gym. If it weren't for that Dig, I probably would have been swept. Alright, but with that, we do need to get a little bit more training in for those guys. Actually, you know what? I know what we could do. Let's head back to the wild area, because I skipped a good portion of my catching that I could do there. Nope. No, not the Pokemon. I want to go to the map, thank you. Alright, so I know I have to skip Dusty Bowl, because those Pokemon are still far too powerful for me. But the ones on Hammerlock Hills on either side of Dusty Hill, I can get. Not to mention, we can pick up some Watts while we're at it. And do any raids that are hanging around. I ran into Snowrunt. Okay, level 30. No, let's not keep him in there like that. Let's see here. Who do I want to put in against this thing? Somebody that won't outright kill it. I think that's going to be a little hard, actually. So, we'll swap to Extinction. Ooh, Ice Shard. Even if Suntire did outspeed this thing, it was still gonna take a hit. So we're gonna Will-O-Wisp this thing. Get rid of its attack stat. Not that it's using it, apparently. Oh yes, I also put the fun item Evil Light on Extinction. So Extinction is now even more bulky than it was before. Aw, it used Protect. Oh, and it's got Ice Body for its ability. Crap. Okay. Well, that complicates things. I may need to swap in Bipolar just to take care of this thing then. But first, we gotta do something about that Ice Shard dealing damage before I put Bipolar in. Bipolar has a decent special defense stat, so she should be able to take all this and start dealing damage to this thing. Because clearly, we're not gonna get anywhere with a burn like I was hoping we would. Alright. Well, here goes nothing, I suppose. And Snorunt tried to protect now. That's good. So we're gonna keep using Draining Kiss just to keep, Bipolar's HP up, because I'm not sure how much damage this will do. It does a decent amount, and with hail it's gonna hurt even more. Alright, but that's certainly enough damage. I can get another Draining Kiss off, and Snowrunt won't faint from that, provided it's not a crit. Dear Lord, that's still... Oh, that was a crit? Ew. No, keep using Ice Shard, please. Alright, I don't think I can go much lower in damage than that, so... We'll just have to try and catch it while it's in yellow. Thankfully, it does still have a status condition, so that makes it easier. And if I need to, I do have a few Ultra Balls I could toss at it. which it looks like I might need to. Ugh. Alright. So first, let's swap bipolar out again, just in case I don't, so that it doesn't have to take another hit. Because I've got no way of healing it. Oh dear, there went Extinction's speed. Because we're so concerned about that. Alright, Snowrun, you're gonna get in this great ball and you're going to like it. See? What did I tell you? The Snowrun likes it. Ooh, Suntanner almost leveled up. Snowrun, the snow hat Pokemon. It can only survive in cold areas. It bounces happily around even in environments as cold as 150 degrees Fahrenheit. Negative 150 degrees Fahrenheit. Alright, and with that, we get to put an egg in our party. And see what it hatches into. So, as much as I want to keep Skylar in, well, yeah, let's take Skylar out for our egg. And now let's figure out what egg we get. So I've reorganized the eggs again. So I have no idea which egg is which one came from anybody. And we'll be randomly number generating it. We are at 13 eggs. Egg number 7. Alright. Then we'll be off to the next area. After we get some more berries. Only one berry. That's sad. Alright, we'll quit it. Whatever you are up there, you can keep yourself there, I guess. Ooh, shiny. A pretty feather. And that's all. Let's see, I believe there's an item up here somewhere. Maybe not. There is another berry tree, however. If I can get around it. The one thing I don't like about the bikes, which is something that actually makes sense for them, is that they're hard to maneuver around at close range. Which, again, is actually common sense. We'll quit there. And now we're getting plenty of berries for camping out here. And I think while we're out here, we might do some raids if I see any. Just so that we can get some XP candy. Alright, new area. What did I just hear? What was that, Choodle? Yeah, that's Choodle. Sure, let's try and catch it. And hope that it doesn't have strong jaw. It's raining! I mean, I could try and keep Suntanner in on this, but I don't think that's a great idea. Let's see here. So I think we'll put Extinction in at the risk of getting... Ooh, counter. So we'll hit it with Ancient Power first, because I don't think we'll KO it with that. I'm hoping we won't KO it with that. Because, as it stands right now, Extinction doesn't have that great of a special attack stat. And now we'll Will-O-Wisp it. So the Will-O-Wisp will take this thing into the yellow and we'll start throwing Pokeballs at it. Ooh, bite. Which did nothing. God damn, Extinction is a very bulky tank with Evilite. Which it won't be able to use for much longer, because I'm hoping that on today's episode it should evolve. Just like Rockstar. They both should evolve in this stream. And Suntanner wants to learn Volt Switch. I am on board for that. We can get rid of U-Turn. Now this is our first time catching Choodle. The snapping Pokemon. It starts off battles by attacking with its rock hard horn, but as soon as the opponent flinches, this Pokemon bites down and never lets go. No, we are not nicknaming this thing. And I am not quite swapping out for an egg yet, just because I want to keep a decent team that I can put into the various Pokemon that we might run into. So for the moment, I'm just going to go back in here and make sure that I remember how many Pokemon I have for this. Alright, we got... How many more places do I have that I can grab Pokemon from? Just one more, it looks like. Because on my way here, I did get Bridgefield and Motostoke Riverbank. Or failed to. One of the two. I don't remember. I could also check Hammerlock to see if there's a fishing area there. I'm not sure if there is one or not. And what do you have for sale today? Anything useful that I might want to try and grab? Actually, you have a lot of useful stuff. Just not anything I can afford. Ah, well. Off to the Stony Wilderness, after I grab whatever that sparkle was. Large Leak. Useful for camping. Okay, it is the Stony Wilderness here. Oh god. I want to find something that's relatively weak, but something that I also won't outright KO. Unfortunately, I think that's looking more and more like Machop. There's also Ninjask, but Ninjask would be a pain to try and catch. Yeah, let's go for Machop. Wait, that was God damn it. Okay, going back to Extinction. Helping Hand? Are you gonna help me attack you? That works for me. Now it's trying to use Fake Out. How about I just give you rocks instead? More rocks. Yeah, I don't think Tyrogue learns anything that could actually hit Extinction. It only has Tackle and Fake Out in order to hit an opponent. So yeah, this thing's definitely not damaging extinction at all. Not that it was gonna get another turn to do so. Probably. Who knows? It might break out. Like that. I'm right out of great balls, though. Dear Lord. What is the catch rate on Tyrogue again? I remember that it is actually a lot higher than you would think, but I don't think it should be breaking out so easily right now. There we go. Alright. So that takes care of those two. Tyrogue, the scuffle Pokemon. Even though it is small, it can't be ignored because it will slug any handy target without warning. Alright, and with that, that's another egg that we'll be able to add to our list. Now we're gonna check. Whoop. No, stay away from me, Bonsweet. We're gonna fly back to Hammerlock again. Real quick to see if there's somewhere to fish in there. Because then that's another capture. If I can catch the Pokemon. If not, well, then it'll be the same as what happened back in Motostoke. Tried fishing, found a Magikarp, accidentally KO'd it. Because it's Magikarp. If I remember correctly, there's a little bit of docks down here. But it doesn't look like there's a fishing spot here. And there might not be, for all I know. Well, while we're here, might as well stop by the Pokemon Center. And see what TMs we can pick up, since I have some excess money. We'll pick up Bullet Seed, just on the off chance that I could use it. I wonder if I can get to the other side of this place right now. Because I know... Oh, there goes the first egg. Let's see what pops out. Ooh, a Vollaby. Interesting. Not exactly a great playthrough Pokemon, in my opinion, just because it's not very offensive, but could still be very useful. Let's see. Vollaby, the diapered Pokemon. Vollaby grow quickly. Bones that have gotten too small for your older Vollaby to wear often get passed down to younger ones in the nest. Let's see here. It's a Vulture. Basically a scavenger. So I think we'll call it that. Unless anyone in chat has a better idea of what to name it. Oh yeah, that thing was definitely... Somebody put Roost on it. I actually already have my own Mandibuzz for competitive use, so this is definitely not a Pokemon that's going to be making it to any of my other games, but still, interesting to have on here. And it's a solid defensive choice for if I want it to fight. Not really ground types, just because most ground types carry rock type coverage, and it's still weak to rock. Unlike Luchador. Oh well. We'll figure that out in a little while. Okay, now time for our next item, or next Pokemon. And it is egg number 3. So that's at least one egg that probably isn't going to be swapped out, unless something faints on me, which is entirely possible. After all, I did lose this playthrough's MVP already. Yeah, unfortunately, we lost Old Timer to a damn Gigantamax Gengar. But that's alright, that's part of the challenge. Part of the challenge, part of the fun. Let's see, anything interesting to hit for XP. Hey, you. Oh, nope, decided it wanted to run away. Granted, I don't blame it. Let's see, and who on my team would I want to be leveling up right now? Looks like Luchador. So Quagsire's probably not the best idea to be doing that with. Nothing on that side is, actually. Ew. Although, I did see a Serena down here earlier that might be good XP. If I don't get KO'd by it. I'm not sure what level it's going to be at. Whoa, hi there, Seismitoad. I really hope this isn't going to be a mistake, but let's find out. If nothing else, I should be able to run from it. It is level 36. So yeah, I should definitely be able to run from it. But we'll put Luchador out and see if we can get it to faint pretty quick. With acrobatics, it should make short work of him. Oh god, it lived. That's concerning. We'll just hit U-turn. That was definitely good XP. Luchador leveled up, Bipolar leveled up, Extinction leveled up, and Suntanner leveled up. Luchador wants to learn Roost. That's actually very tempting. Buy Steel Wing. That's alright. Steel Wing's a TM, so I can teach it back to Luchador if I feel the need to. Alright, now then, does Extinction evolve now? Nope, not quite yet. Alright, this area was filled with Ninjasks earlier. Oh, but first we hatch an egg. And we got another Applin, which means duplication rule. So we get another egg. And we'll put that one right away into the party, so it's still this egg that we're hatching. We've already got an Applin, so not going to bother nicknaming that one. Though I do want to see what this one looks like. No egg moves. Then again, I don't think Applin can actually get any egg moves. And it looks like another defensive one. So also, don't want it for a playthrough on those grounds. So we've gotten 3 Applins and 2 Cleffas. Anyways, what's the next egg? 13. Lucky number 13, right, guys? Oh, wait, that's right. Yesterday, we hatched one of the duplicates with number 13. So, lucky number, right, guys? Alright, ninjas, let's go. A wild ninjask appeared. Alright, we'll put Luchador in again. Yes, Ninjask, you want to be faster. You want all the speed. Because all of your attack comes from your speed. Actually, I would be very concerned if Game Freak ever developed a move that was based off the speed stat. Because that thing would be overpowered. Because speed is arguably one of the most important stats in this game. Wait, that thing learns Absorb? Well, actually, I'm not surprised by that, but I didn't think it was in its move pool. Ah, well. More ninjasks. These guys should be decent XP at least. Now, if I actually believed Sun Tanner would be faster than Ninjask originally, I would just Volt Switch right out of this. But I don't. And I'd rather not take the chance that he faints from an attack. Goodbye, Sun Tanner. My lord, these things love agility. Oh boy. So I think that's what, 3 times speed right there? No, 2.5. I'm using Luchador against Ninjask, not just because Acrobatics one-shots it, but also because Luchador is a flying and fighting type that's a quad resistance to his main stab, and Ninjask also does not learn any flying type moves. At least as far as I'm aware, that might have changed. But if it learned a flying move, my guess is it would probably be Air Slash or Air Cutter, which isn't all that useful for it, since it doesn't have a special attack stat. Get over here, Ninjask. You're decent XP out of most of these things. False Swipe, I did know it knew. And finally, we see a different move on one of these things than Agility. Oh, and it only needed the one speed in order to outspeed Luchador. Which I'm not surprised by in the slightest. That is Ninjask's thing, is that it is one of the fastest Pokemon. Okay, Sun Tanner and Rockstar both leveled up. Ooh, and Rockstar is evolving. And now I have an Obstagoon, which is probably going to be the most powerful Pokemon on this team now. Obstagoon, the blocking Pokemon. It evolved after experiencing numerous fights. While crossing its arms, it lets out a shout that would make any opponent flinch. And now he wants to learn Obstruct. Honestly, Obstruct for playthrough is not great. It's the same reason why I don't keep moves like Protect and Detect. All it does is just stall when I would most of the time would rather just straight up hit something. Alright, so I'm curious to see what its attack stat looks like. 85. Which is actually better than Luchador's right now. Though, as soon as Luchador levels up, it'll probably be even. But he is far bulkier than Luchador. Which is very unsurprising. That is kind of Rockstar's thing, is that he's supposed to be bulky. Actually, we should probably go back in and set one of these guys aside, because that's the egg we're working on right now. Because we got a duplicate egg, that's right. I'm losing track of what I'm doing. That also doesn't surprise me at all. I don't see any dens, though. Anything with raids in it. Weird. Oh wait, it's probably because I already went through a good portion of them. I mean, I could head back to the other area too in order to get more. Let's see here. Let's see, Seismitoad's right there. We won't be hitting him, though, very hard. Oh, wait. Let's put Obstagoon away for the moment. Because Ninetales takes longer to level up, and it's only level 35 anyways. So this way we can swap Skylar in, hopefully, without too many repercussions. Just gotta figure out what Pokemon I want to hit, if any. Ooh, there's a throw. That might be worth something, actually. At level 28, Bipolar might actually be able to take this thing. But I'd rather not risk that. Let's go, Skylar. And now we're making it hail. Ooh, revenge, that's going to hurt. But we got leftovers to save ourselves. And even though we can't see the moon, thanks to all the hail, we can still use Moonblast. That's a decent amount of XP, actually. Though I'm assuming that throws are probably pretty rare in the in this grass, so probably can't go exploring for them. Ooh, Conkeldurr. Part of me wants to try and fight it, because that's a lot of XP. But in order to do that, I should probably make sure that Luchador is first fully healed. Because it'll be the one that I swap into that. Just because it's the only one that resists it and can fight it easily. And I don't want Extinction to take an accidental. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. This was a mistake. Oh, crap. Crap. Guys, I got problems. This was clearly a mistake. Go, Luchador. Live. And let us run. I don't have a Poke Doll to befriend this thing with. Oh, boy. Thank the Lord for that. Note to self, go buy Poke Dolls. They will save you. Especially when I try to be stupid like that. Fighting a level 55 Pokemon with my level 30 average team is not a great idea. So it seems like some of these Pokemon are still basically off limits for me to fight. Like, I bet the Corviknight that spawns over here probably is similar level to that Conkeldurr. Ugh. And probably that Vikavolt, too. So I don't think there's going to be anything worth fighting over in this. Oh, no. Actually, Lombres are decent. We also found a Beware. Okay. So we learned last time that extinction basically destroys this thing. Actually, it used to. Not anymore. Now that I got rid of Swift and Nature Power, because Hex has no effect on this thing. So I guess we'll just burn this thing and swap out to something else. Probably Luchador. No, actually with the burn we should be able to swap to Skylar. Because Skylar still needs to level up. And it's not going to do that by not entering combat. Oh god, I was really hoping for Flail. Eh, that didn't do too much, actually. And Leftovers will heal off some of that. Time for a Moonblast. Eh, you can endure all you want. You've got two things that are going to kill you either way. And Beware gets pelted by the hail and faints. Decent XP. And now going into Lombres. Lombres is decent XP, though I think that Beware was probably worth more. Ooh, Lombres is actually level 36. That may or may not be a problem. But it's also a water grass type, which means it really doesn't like freeze dry. Oh god. That's a stab energy ball coming from this thing. That's not good. Lombres takes damage from hail, Skylar heals damage thanks to leftovers, and we're going to freeze-dry him. At level 36, though, this thing probably is actually good XP. Alright, both Suntanner and Bipolar leveled up, and Suntanner's trying to learn Parabolic Charge, which we will replace Thundershock with. So Suntanner can heal himself now. And Bipolar wants to learn Charm. Let's not. Here's one thing. I actually don't know when Suntanner evolves. I don't use him, so it's just something that I never learned. So give me a second, because I'm kind of curious now. I'm pretty sure it's a level up evolution, so I won't need a stone for it, but I could be wrong. Oh, I am wrong. I need a sunstone for it. Okay, next question. Is there any reason not to evolve it now? Let's see, it learns Thunderbolt naturally. So that would be a good reason not to evolve it. And I don't think... Oh, no. Yep, I have no reason not to evolve it. Okay. Where's that sunstone? Because I know I have one. But see, this is how little I actually know about this guy. Sun Tanner has evolved. Heliolisk, the generator Pokemon. One Heliolisk basking in the sun with its frills outspread is all it would take to produce enough electricity to power a city. That's a terrifying amount of power, actually. Okay, anyways, let's see some important stats from this thing. 72 speed, 75 special attack. Nice. So it already outpaces Course Extinction for special attack, which isn't hard. And it outpaces Skylar. My point is... has been proven, again, that as much as I love Skylar, I can't use it as my special offensive Pokemon. Oh, that Pokemon, whatever it is in a Beast Ball. Nice, I love Beast Ball. It is actually tied for second as my favorite Pokeball. First is Luxury Ball, but then it's Premier and, Beast Ball tied. But the games never gave you enough Beast Balls to use, so can't really do much about that. Alright, Skylar's going back in. And hopefully we're not taking an attack this turn. Though Skylar should be able to take whatever it is. Here comes another energy ball, unfortunately. Alright, now time for a freeze dry. Alright, Extinction has leveled up again. Is it going to evolve this time? There we are! What? Extinction is evolving? Alright, Extinction has evolved into Cursola. The Coral Pokemon. Be cautious of the ectoplasmic body surrounding its soul. You'll become stiff as stone if you touch it. Oh boy. Alright, so that means that Evolite is now useless on it, unfortunately, so we'll take that off. And I want to see what this thing's stats look like now. Because its stats change actually quite greatly. It drops all defense that it has. But it gets increased special attack, physical attack, and special defense. I think its speed also drops a little bit. Alright. So, and now we also have a new ability on Extinction. When hit by a move that makes direct contact, the Pokemon and the attacker will faint after 3 turns, unless they switch out of battle. Essentially, a Parasong on contact. Which is great in some aspects, but I got to watch my timing on this, because if I'm not paying attention, I could easily lose extinction to fainting. And then it would be in the box, joined with Old Timer. Which would not be great. Okay, let's camp. However, one great thing about this guy now is that Extinction has a very, very useful special attack stat. Hi, Curlia. Let's get cooking. And let's see here. Is there anything that's we have an abundance of? Alright, so we're adding a leek and Greppa and Kelpsy berries. And since I'm by myself, I have entire control of how this goes. I am a professional button masher, by the way. I got very good at it because I had several games as a kid where button mashing was a requirement. So I learned to get pretty good at it, developed a decent way to do it. So if there's ever times when I need to do button mashing, I'm good. The fire looks pretty good. I'm wondering what kind of rank I get from this. Leek curry. That does not look appetizing in the least to me. But apparently the character in Pokemon like it. Ooh, Copper is our class. Let's see, HP and PP were restored, status conditions healed, got a lot of XP, and they all got far more friendly with me. I only did that for the healing HP, and that's not a lot of XP. I'm sorry, game. Alright, let's see what the Watt Trader has for today. Taunt, Bug Buzz, Heavy Slam, Surf, and Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball would be very useful, but I don't think we're gonna get up to 3,000 watts right now. Not to mention I'd have to remember to come back down to this place. Actually, Kangler, where'd you go? You're a pretty slow Pokemon. Except that I have Bipolar in the front, not Suntanner. So, slight risk. I'm putting Suntanner in against this thing. And yes, that hurts. Ow. Parabolic Charge time. Give me that health back. Oh dear lord, that was a KO. Is that enough to heal them fully? It is. Nice. So those two gain massive XP. Alright, what do we have in this then? Ooh, Gigantamax Eevee. So we'll invite other people. And I gotta figure out what I want to use against this thing. I guess Luchador would be my best bet, despite the fact that he doesn't have a fighting move. Though it looks like I got plenty of people to join me, so this should be easy. Dear Lord. This'll be a quick one. It's only a 3-star. Provided that we can get this Raziel person to go. I kind of feel bad for these guys. They're going to be dragging my sorry carcass through this fight. Alright, and Gigantamax Eevee is not worth catching, in my opinion. So, we're just doing this for the, candies. Candies and items. Which, hopefully, he'll be dropping, body slams. Oops, I forgot to Dynamax. Not that it matters too much, actually. Somebody else can Dynamax if they need to. Or we could just straight up KO it like that. Goodbye, Eevee. Let's see, medium candy, like XP candy large, Grappa Berry, Uproar, and Encore. Okay. So a large XP candy is worth 10,000 experience, I believe. Which is quite a bit. Hi, Galvantula. It would get most Pokemon up to at least level 20, I believe. And we got a Metapod, 2-star. Let's see. Honestly, Hawlucha's probably going to be the easiest one to go through with this. And we don't care if nobody's joining us. Because why do we need people on a 2-star? And I can't think of too many people who would want a Metapod. Let's go, Luchador! And hey, we got Wishiwashi this time. Last time we got Wishiwashi, it was too low level to use its ability schooling. Goodbye, Metapod. Get wrecked. And we are not catching this thing, because I don't need it. Ooh, Leech Life as a TM. Record, that's actually pretty decent. Well, no Tyrogue. Bad Tyrogue. I do not want to fight you again. Let's not take on the Butterfree, because I don't want it spreading status throughout my team. Oops, we got something. That was unintentional. Hi, Squovit. That thing's not even worth beating the crap out of. And there were no berry. There was only one berry, so yeah. Ooh, a 2-star Quagsire. I'm pretty sure nobody wants in on this, but, let's see here. Obstagoon, where are you? Let's see if this thing likes eating a seed bomb. I'm sure it'll love it. And this will be Obstagoon's first battle. Max Overgrowth. Alright, Rockstar, you know what to do. Oh, and Eevee is using Helping Hand. I will be very surprised if this Quagsire survives. Actually, I would have been surprised before, even more surprised now. But there goes the Quagsire. Quagmire, is that you? Well, we certainly don't need to catch that thing. Power Gem and Earth Power. Nice. Looks like we only have one more raid area before it resets. That's alright. We'll get this last one. Then I'm going to go grab Shadow Ball from the Watt Trader that we found earlier. And continue training, I guess. We'll put Suntanner in here first. Because this Pelipper is not going to like us if... It is raining. And this poor Pelipper is going to faint over it. Yes, I entirely needed that crit in order to KO the Pelipper. One more level and Bipolar will evolve. And we are still hatching whatever egg this is. Because, you know, I've actually entirely forgotten that I have this egg with me. And that is a Palpitoad, it looks like. Let's not use Heliolisk against him. Instead, let's bring our good friend Rockstar in against this thing. Because, you know, grass types. Hi there, Palpitoad. Meet Rockstar, your doom. And apparently you're not allowed to use water according to Torkoal. Dynamax real quick, max overgrowth, and that should be it. But we'll see. I'm not sure of the leveling ratio between all of these Pokemon. All these raid Pokemon, it's just weird to me. Oh, and Eevee just used Helping Hand. This is gonna hurt a lot. Though it is a 3-star, which means it does have a shield. That hopefully my team is going to break through. Actually, no, they won't break through, because each shield is at least 2. And this one's got 3. Ooh, Max Quake. Good thing I just set up grassy terrain, though I don't know if that helps. Oh, there went Heatmore. Oh boy. Heatmore, you weren't supposed to let that happen. Alright, come on. Max Overgrowth again. And I guess we'll be the one to take out the shield. Okay, so my team's levels are probably comparable to the 3-star raid dens, because that didn't do what the close combat did to the Eevee earlier. Ooh, Torkoal is using Rapid Spin. The turtle wants to go fast. And Heatmore is back in just to see Palpitoad go down. One more Max Overgrowth. Goodbye, Palpitoad. And we are not catching this thing. Let's see, we got Scald, Liquidation, and Muddy Water. Not bad TM set, actually. Alright, but that should be over 3,000 watts for us, so we'll head back to the Watt Trader. Grab Shadow Ball, and of course teach that to, Extinction. Because, you know, Extinction could use a ghost type move that isn't affected by status conditions. Oh, and we're finally getting this egg to hatch. And this was the one that replaced our duplicate, so that means we still have one more egg to hatch. Ooh, Dreppy. Lingering Pokemon. If this weak Pokemon is by itself, a mere child could defeat it. But if Dreppy has friends to help it train, it can evolve and become much stronger. Okay. Now here's the question. What are we gonna nickname Dreppy? Oh boy. You know, I thought this would be easy, but I'm drawing blanks on this. Because we've already made a canon joke with Remoraid, so don't want to go through with that. We'll go with that for now. Whee! Because that's exactly the sound that Dreppy makes as it gets launched out of people's heads. So Dreppy's actually interesting. I'm not overly sure what I want to do with this thing. It's in a Beast Ball, which is nice. And this one is Modest, so that's actually somewhat of a copy of my competitive Dragapult, actually. Mine is focused on special attack instead of physical attack. I don't think it's going to make the team, though. Just because I don't necessarily want to use overpowered Pokemon. Alright, now time for the last egg. Egg 12. And that should be the last egg we'll probably hatch on today's episode. We'll have to see how long I decide to go on for after I get through a slight amount of training here. Spend my watts, get that shadow ball. Actually, one thing I should check is when Extinction learns shadow ball on its own. See if it's even worth using that TM on it. I should have done that before I bought it, but oh well. Let's see. Cerebee is your best friend. So it does not learn Shadow Ball on its own. Okay, so nope, that was worth buying. So we'll get rid of Hex. Let's see what other special attacks we'll want to teach it. I could teach it Power Gem to replace Ancient Power. Can't teach it Energy Ball. I can teach it Earth Power, though. So let's do that. And I think we'll get rid of Will-O-Wisp, just because Strength Sap does the same job as what Will-O-Wisp does. But it also heals Extinction. Let's see, anything else we want to try and teach anybody? Extinction can learn Pin Missile. Let's see. And Extinction can learn Scald. Oh boy. So I can still spread burns and keep Strength Sap as well. I call that a win. Alright, let's go through all those Lombre. Sun Tanner should be faster than all these Lombre. So I can Volt Switch out. And that actually did decent damage. And go straight to Skylar. Fury Swipes. That's not fun. Hey you, quit trying to swipe at Skylar. What did Skylar ever do to you? I mean, granted, if you want to think about it this way, it's what Skylar is about to do to you that should be a concern. All right, I won't actually fight all the Lombres, but I will go through them, through the ones that are in my way. Just because they're decent XP. Again with the Fury Swipes. Dear Lord, can you guys just leave poor Skylar alone? Alright. Time to freeze the water type. Alright, Sun Tanner is now level 30. Oh, nope, not what I wanted to do. Ah well, easy enough to swap things around like that too. Alright, but one of my main missions was accomplished now for today, and that was to get Extinction and... Sound is lagging. That's not good. I don't know. My stream app seems to be having problems recently with lagging sound. We'll use Luchador for this. And I'm pretty sure nobody wants to join in on this fight, so we'll just use Luchador and whatever Pokemon we get with us. Though it wouldn't surprise me if it gave me a team with Wishiwashi, all the other water types, I don't know. Let's see. Mudbrick. Yeah. This team is utter crap. Granted, it's not the worst team they could have given me, but it's pretty close. Jolteon doesn't have a good move to hit Roselia with. Mudbray is going to take super effective damage, and Throw has the same problem as Jolteon. Because all of Throw's moves are fighting. Alright, there's its barrier, which will hopefully be broken by my partners. There we go, the sound's back to normal. So it wasn't my laptop, it's actually my stream app that's doing the sound problems. Originally, I thought that the sound lag was just because I only just opened up my laptop. Mudbray lived! Thanks to a sash. But anyways, but now that the sound lag has come back again, seems like it's probably actually my stream app that's having problems. Eh, we didn't quite break the barrier. Which is unfortunate, because that means we have to go through another turn of attacks, probably. Yep. Though with Roselia's reduced defenses, hopefully my team can KO this thing. One Mega Punch from Throw will probably do it, actually. Bye, Jolteon. My lord. Why can't my team be useful? One thing I wish Game Freak did was put actually good Pokemon for raids in this. I mean, granted, not overpowering ones where, like, they'll win the raid for you, but still, it's like, the randoms that they put on this is just ridiculous. Actually, one thing I would like them to do is give us the choice on who actually joins us in instances like this. Alright, we got a bunch of shrooms from the grass type, plus energy ball and grass knot. Not bad. Hi, beware. What level are you? You encountered a very strong looking beware. Oh, I'm guessing I can't actually catch it then. Ooh, it's level 42. I do have problems then. Okay, how do I want to handle this? This is very much a problem. Oh god. So Luchador should be able to run from this thing. But that was a higher level than I was expecting. Otherwise I wouldn't have bothered with that. Oh well. Plenty of raids here, so... The only thing is that I don't actually have a genuine need for all the candies I would get from it right now. I only have one more egg to hatch, and between the large and the mediums, XP candies I already have, I probably don't need any more. But who knows? I'll still do the raids anyways, just because it'll get me records. Oh, got another Eevee. Alright, let's get this started. That Eevee just looks like it's plotting something nasty. Alright, it's only 2-star, so it won't have a barrier, thankfully, so I'm hoping that G-Max Acrobatics will be a one-shot this thing. But I'm probably wrong. No, close to a 2-shot, though. Which means next turn this thing's definitely done. G-Max Cuddle! Critical hits. I need to figure out what that Cuddle does. Because that sounds... Oh god. No, please, no. I do not need all of our Pokemon infatuated with this thing. Granted, one thing with infatuation is that it is gender-based, so at least some of our Pokemon can't be infatuated against it, probably. Ooh, we got Hyper Voice. Nice. Alright, and this is our last egg for now. Let's see what pops out of this one. Ooh, Tyrogue. Gotta see what sort of egg moves they put on this thing. Okay, what to call this leak? Okay, you know what? Hitmonchamp! Why? Because I don't know any other famous fighters. Alright, but with that, I'm probably... There's very little that would get this Hitmonchamp in order to join my team. It's got Guts, and it looks like it was made to be defensive. So this person probably planned it to be a... Let's see, it got Rapid Spin and Fake Out. So yeah, this thing was probably meant to be a Hitmontop. Well, with that, looks like my team is not going to change for the moment. I don't know why Impidimp was in there. Did I hatch an egg for that Impidimp then? I'll err on the side of caution and don't. Ooh, Lantern. That's an interesting one. Not sure who I want to use against that, I guess. I'll probably just end up using Rockstar again. Three star. I don't think anybody's going to come help me with a three star lantern, though. So we'll head straight in and see if we can have Obstagoon at least clean this up. Let's see, we've got Weavile, Solrock, and Hawlucha. Two of those Pokemon I'm not excited about in the slightest. And in the top left, you can see why. They're both using status moves. Hawlucha is using Feather Dance, and Solrock is using a useless Cosmic Power. Because if this thing decides to use a water move on Solrock, Solrock's probably gone anyways. Alright, there's a great deal of damage. But I don't think that's Barrier. It is not. Why is Rockstar faster than the Weavile? Oh dear. Max Lightning. No, not the Weavile! The Weavile is actually the useful one! I would have preferred that you had used that on either Rockstar or Soul Rock. God damn it. Well, there went one useful attacker. And we do know this thing actually does hurt some. I didn't see what the other two were doing. It really doesn't matter. Because I don't expect them to be useful. Not in the slightest. No, buy electric terrain. You are not getting a boost to your electric attacks. Alright, three portion barrier. Hey, Halucha's actually attacking. Yay. Oh, there go any stat changes we had. Which I think was none. Ooh, now it's time for Max Geyser. Who is it aimed at? It is, of course, aimed at Solrock. So now we can only afford to have one more Pokemon faint on us. But this Solrock seems to have our number pretty good. It knew to use a water move against... Oh god. Oh god. Did I say we could afford to have one more Pokemon faint? I meant to say that we are probably pretty screwed here. Unless that assurance does a lot of damage this turn. Or that lantern decides that I'm the bigger threat. Not quite enough damage. Oh. Weavile lived! Did I say Weavile lived? I meant we lost this. My lord. I swear, this game gives you the worst teams ever. We lost in three turns. That is terrible. I'm gonna try it again, because that's just... No. That shouldn't have happened. Well, we got a random person to join us, and they're using Pikachu. I'm going to assume this is a Gigantamax Pikachu. And I'm honestly not going to let them do the Gigantamax. Well, no, I should. What I'm really hoping for is that this is a Lightning Rod Pikachu, in case this thing knows something other than Discharge. Okay, so looks like we have a bulkier team this time around, at least. We've got Snorlax and Clefairy. I'm gonna seed bomb this thing. Nope, and the Lantern knows not to use an electric move right now. But that is definitely a higher level Pikachu than my Obstagoon. So hopefully this means that we'll be able to actually do something to it. And now, if it weren't for the fact that the Pikachu is going to Dynamax, as I'm sure. Oh, no, it's not. It's just going to go straight for Thunder. Oh, there's the barrier. Ooh, the Snorlax barely survived the geyser. Well, there's Pikachu's lightning rod, but it doesn't save everybody. It only saves itself. So there goes the Snorlax. But that's our first casualty, and probably going to be our only casualty, actually. Because after the shield's broken, either I should be able to KO it with Seed Bomb. Come on, buddy, it's not that hard of a decision. Just click Thunder again. You'll hit it. Because this thing doesn't have Volt Absorb. Heck, any attacking move would do right now. Just break the damn shield so I can take down the lantern. Alright, there goes the shield. He drops HP from the shield breaking. And I hit it with Seed Bomb, and it should faint. There we are. Not gonna bother catching it. Ooh, we got Thunderbolt. Not that anybody actually needs it. Because our friend Sun Tanner learns it naturally. Or through remembering, actually. Not quite naturally. And now we got Boldore. We'll see if anybody's crazy enough to want to join us on this. Let's see, nobody has any stab moves that are super effective against it. So I think... You know what? I'm curious. I want to see what Perish Body does in a battle like this. Oh, but we did actually get somebody. And they have an Inteleon, so they're at least as high-leveled as I am. And we got Charizard, too. Very interesting. That's two more people than I was expecting to join this. Now if only they could select their Pokemon and we could get this going. Beware. Interesting choice. And Toxtricity. Okay. So now I'm just going to hope that we aren't taking discharges to the face with that Toxtricity. Alright, let's Max Geyser this thing. Though actually, if this thing knows any rock type move, it'll just set up Sandstorm on me. But that's alright. Oh god! And it's got three barrier pieces to break through. I take care of two of them right off the bat. And it looks like Cuddles, the Beware, gets to take another one off. Then my turn to destroy it. And then Maractus, as long as it didn't use Solar Beam, can finish it off. Hey, look, it used solar beam. Have fun trying to gather sunlight through the damn rainstorm. Oh, there's Max Rockfall. Which means now it's time for Sandstorm. And now it's using Mud Slap. It really does not like that beware, does it? Again, not bothering to catch it. We're doing this for the items. Another Earth Power record. Okay. Is there anybody to attack around here? Oop, I hit something. How's it going, DeGoat? I see wind. That's still dealing a great deal of damage, actually. Hey, how about giving some of that health back that you're gaining? Yeah, Bipolar isn't doing very well, but then again, before Bipolar evolves, it's very weak. I have an idea, though. Let's get to the other side of this place, because there were plenty of good Pokemon that I could level off of. I saw Noctowls, I saw... I saw Dreadnoughts. I saw Quagsires. Now the question is what level are these guys? Alright, Rockstar, let's put you in. That was a crit. Oh, boy. Yeah, didn't like that Rocky Helmet, did you, Dreadnought? Or the Seed Bomb, I'm sure. We're going to evolve Bipolar, and then we'll move on to the gym. Oh, it's using Fight. That definitely would not have been a good thing for Bipolar to take, especially judging by how much damage it did to Rockstar. Oh well, the dreadnought's gone. Alright, two Pokemon leveled up from that. Luchador and Bipolar. But Bipolar is now evolving, so that'll be good. Alright, Gardevoir, the Embrace Pokemon. To protect its trainer, it will expend all its psychic power to create a small black hole. That is terrifying. You guys do not want to be anywhere near a black hole, no matter its size. And that wants to learn Dazzling Gleam. Why not? We'll get rid of Swift. I don't need Swift. And I like having some form of healing. Alright, now that Bipolar has evolved, we're gonna head back to the Ballonlea. And go and fight ourselves a gym leader. But now my team is fully evolved Pokemon. Actually, what does Bipolar stats even look like? Okay, now Extinction has the highest special attack and highest special defense. Though Gardevoir might be in competition for both of those once it actually catches up. And my fastest Pokemon is Luchador, with Skylar not too far behind. And I'm guessing that Suntanner will probably be up there in those rankings as well. I should probably start buying Hyper Potions if I can, though. Oh, I did buy Hyper Potions. Okay. Alright, off to go and fight the fairy gym. After I collect some items. TM21, rest. Hi, Chin Chow. And we found a balm mushroom. Oh, Challenger Belvedere. You got 4 badges already? I'm gonna have to watch out for you, huh? Yeah. Look, even Morpeko is wary of you. Wait, Morpeko, don't tell me you actually like Belvedere. Ugh, we've already had a serious battle with her. She's an opposing gym leader. Guess there's nothing to it. Or gym challenger. Just take one of my league cards, okay? Thanks, Marnie. What's with that look, huh? This just means I'll think of you as my rival from now on, okay? There aren't too many gym challengers left, you know, so we're meeting in the finals. You got that? Oh yes, Marty, I would love to battle you again. Hey there, thanks for rolling by to have a chat with your mate, the ball guy. Is love in the air, or is it just this Pokeball? Here, try it out and see for yourself. A love ball is useful if you want to catch a Pokemon that's the opposite gender of the one you send out onto the battlefield. Pokeballs are just so full of surprises, don't you think? I've been hearing more and more people talk about you, Challenger Belvedere. Yes, yes, fangirl, I know. I'm actually pretty good. Hey there, Trash. Nope. The only Pokemon we've still lost thus far is, Old Timer, unfortunately. Though, to be fair, Oldtimer probably would have been lost in this gym as well. It's full of fairies. And we all know that dragons hate fairies, apparently, right? Though I have come close, I've ran into a couple really strong Pokemon that I didn't think I'd be able to get away from. Oh, there you are, my dear gym challenger. Though you are really lacking in the color pink. See, I'm looking for a successor to take on the role of gym leader here. So my gym mission serves as an audition of sorts, too. Oh, don't worry, it's simple enough. All you need to do is battle my trainers and answer the questions they ask along the way. Think carefully before answering, though, child. If you get the wrong answer, the stats of your Pokemon will get lowered. Oh, but if you answer correctly, your Pokemon will get a stat boost. Just think of it as a little fairy-type Pokemon magic to make things interesting. Now, I want you to go all out. Show me what you can do. So, Trash, how was the rest of your stream? And speaking of your stream, gotta remember to do this because I'm terrible at it. Now, let the gym mission begin. Battle with all your skill. Alright, okay. It's time to start your audition to see if you're worthy of becoming the fairy-type gym leader. We are challenged by gym trainer Annette, who sends out Spirit Sea. Oh boy. No problem, Trash. Okay, let's see here. Level 34. I could probably deal with that. Wait, this thing knows Psychic? Why does it know Psychic and Bipolar doesn't? Actually, crap, I forgot to do Remembering Moves. Question. Do you know about Fairy-type's weaknesses? I mean, they're weak to both Poison and Steel. That's right. One of the Fairy-type's weaknesses is the Poison-type. And Bipolar just got a significant attack boost. They were both correct answers to GOAT. Alright, and now we got Slurpuff to deal with. Fake tears? What's it gonna do with those fake tears? Oh, there went my special defense. How sad. Goodbye, Slurpuff. Meanwhile, Extinction is going pretty nicely. If you stand your ground with everything you got, it doesn't matter what's right or wrong. I mean, fair enough, in these fights, I can get the answers wrong and still win. Or just swap out my Pokemon. I see. I can't say what Miss Opal will think, but you've at least piqued my interest. I don't care about any of your guys' interests, I just want the gym badge. Dear Lord, give me the gym badge already. I'm the second trainer. Don't worry about the last question. Let's keep moving forward. And this time it's gym trainer Teresa, who is sending out Swirlix. Hey, we managed to confuse it too. That's what I've been aiming for this entire time with Psybeam. And it even hit itself. Nice. Question. What was the previous trainer's name? Oh dear, the previous trainer's name was Annette. I hit that far too fast. Oops. I was too busy pressing A and it kind of went through that. I didn't even have a chance to look at the question properly. Of the answers. So Gardevoir is now slow. Though I'm not sure if it's any slower than that Aromatis. Nope, it's still faster than the Aromatis, so that speed drop mattered nothing. And it still wants to use Confusion. Oh, come on! Eh, I suppose I got Confusion during the last, on that Swirlix, so I suppose the special defense drop is only fair. Oh, come on, I don't need more of these statuses. How's it going, zombie? Glad you could make it. Isn't this a little late for you, though? Actually, yeah, for you, if you're in North Carolina, that means it's about midnight. So, both Bipolar and Suntanner have fully evolved, and so has Extinction and Rockstar Zombie, so we've got a fully evolved team. Fair enough, Zombie. To be cautious and wary, that's the trick to survival. Don't worry about right or wrong, just keep moving forward. Oh, don't worry, I'm keep moving forward as I'm slowly taking you guys all out. So you get to sleep in, zombie? I wish I could do that. I don't get to do that until the next day, where I finally have 2 days off. I've been working almost straight since Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday, I think. And those have all been near 8-hour shifts. I'm next. I think you might have what it takes to become the fairy-type gym leader. I don't want to be a fairy-type gym leader. I just want to get the gym badges and beat Leon. Thank you. Okay. Let's see here. The goat, you should fix that. You should sleep. Alright, so we're gonna Dazzling Gleam this Morgrem. Question. What do I eat for breakfast every morning? Omelets. Correct, I prefer cheese omelets. Hooray, I've got more bulk now. Maybe I'll live whatever Morgrem's cooking up. If I don't outright KO it with this. False surrender. That's not very nice, Morgrem. Oh boy. To be fair, zombie, I think most people who work retail aren't people persons anyways. I'm usually not. Oh god. So, can my level 31 bipolar beat its reflection at level 35? Let's find out. Oh god. Ooh, and I snapped out of confusion too. And thanks to that flatter, that's a lot of special attack for Gardevoir, for Bipolar. So I think we can out-heal and damage this Gardevoir. Give me my health back, and quit trying to steal it. Oh, Mystical Fire, that's not good. It's trying to lower my special attack. How dare it? Oh no, it just lived, barely. Ooh. Sorry about that, guys. As I'm sure you all heard, I just smacked my headphones. Alright, we beat Theodora. I play a strong trainer. I'm a method actor, so I became a trainer in real life, too. We should be focusing on the gym challenge, but Miss Opal insisted on making this an audition. Well, we've answered all of her damn questions. Now time to heal my Pokemon and move on. Actually, I only need to heal one. Bipolar actually went through all of those Pokemon pretty handily. Okay, so this gym might be a slight problem. I don't have any switch-ins for fairies, and I have half of my actual fighting team right now is weak to fairy. So this may or may not hurt a lot. As long as it doesn't get to the Gengar levels of, oh crap. Congratulations, you have successfully completed the gym mission. Now, I wonder if you've met the standards of the gym leader. Would you like to immediately challenge the gym leader, Challenger Belvedere? Yes, please. Ooh, your friend sent you a surprise? That's cool. And a custom-made scarf as well. Pretty damn nice. I'm not very arts and crafty myself, so I wouldn't be able to do that. Sailor Moon themed. I never actually watched Sailor Moon. I thought I might try and pick it up, but I don't think I have access to it at this point. Hey look, Opal is waiting for us. How nice of her. I suppose it's a bit late to introduce myself, but I'm Opal, the gym leader. I've gotten a good look at how you handled those quizzes. The last part of the mission is me. Let me have a look at how you and your partner Pokemon behave. Oh, if it's on Hulu, then I should have access to it, but I guess I'll live with the subtitles. And we are challenged by Opal, and she does not look happy. Oh god. Galarian wheezing. Kinda wish that we kept, let's see, Volt Switch. Let's put Obstagoon in, actually. Wait, that was a terrible idea. Oh, crap. Oh, nope, you sludge. Question. You, do you know my nickname? The Wizard. Ding, ding, ding. Congratulations, you're correct. Well, my speed rose. Unfortunately, that's not what I want. Alright, zombie, so you and your friend are gonna have matching scarves then. Alright. Let's get Obstagoon out of here before she eats a fairy type move. Let's go, Skylar. Fairy Wind. That didn't do too much. And now it's time for Extra Sensory. Goodbye, Weezing. Okay, so that takes care of that problem, child. After putting all of my Pokemon in here. Okay. Opal, you do realize that Togekiss has a problem here, right? Please tell me you do. You're a gym leader. You should know these things. But I'll be glad to teach you if you don't. Oh, that's why she put it in. That's gonna hurt. Question. What is my favorite color? This is actually a trick question. Her favorite color is purple. Yes, a nice deep purple. Truly grand, don't you think? Ooh, Skylar now just got a bunch of defensive boosts. Anyways, Freeze Dry will be enough to KO Togekiss from here. Oh god, Mawile! Oh. Crap, how do I want to handle this one? Well, Skylar has to get out of there because it can't eat a steel move. And I don't want to put Extinction in quite yet. Oh, nope, it's still using Draining Kiss. The hail stopped, thankfully. Alright, so we're gonna dig here and see what it tries to do. Hey, Mawile. Eat Hawlucha's favorite move. The move that single-handedly saved this entire team from the last gym. Oh, it knows that. Iron Defense. That's not great. Question. Alrighty then. How old am I? You're 16 years old. Ha! I like your answer. Alright, going back underground. No more iron defenses for you, Mawile. Alright, Luchador leveled up, Extinction leveled up, and Skylar leveled up as well. Oh, and it learns Power Gem all on its own. But I like its moves as is. So, we'll live with that. My morning tea is finally kicking in, and not a moment too soon. Alright, so now we get to deal with Alcremie. But we're not letting Hawlucha stay in against this thing. Are you prepared? I'm going to have some fun with this! Oh dear. Okay, so the question here is, what do I have that can live from this thing? I think I only have one thing that will. And that is Extinction. Alright, Extinction, time for your true debut. You lack pink. Here, let us give you some. Oh god, I don't want pink. No, stay away! Okay, so we're going to hit with Max Quake in order to increase our special defense against this thing. Because most of its moves are special attack based. Congratulations, guys. You have pissed off the giant haunted coral. Oh dear lord! That special attack stats! Extinction. And that's a move without stab right there. Dear lord. I think this Alcremie is in for some pain and suffering. At the hands of extinction. Oh, you piece of crap. Oh, it went through, though. Time to die, Alcremie. Yeah, I have no regrets about having Extinction on my team. I have defeated Opal, who just threw away her umbrella. Your pink is still lacking, but you're an excellent trainer with some excellent Pokemon. And I got 12,000 for that. Nice. Well, good try. Not bad. Not bad at all. Still not what I'm looking for. Oh, don't worry yourself about it, child. It's just a matter of my preference. I'll find the next gym leader elsewhere. In fact, I've already got an idea about where to look. Too bad about the audition, but here's a fairy badge for your efforts. Hooray, that's gym badge number 6. No, 5. That's gym badge number 5. I can't count. Take this TM2 with you. It's a little bonus from this old lady. Draining Kiss. Alright. Lastly, here's a little something for humoring me. This might help add a little pink more to you. A fairy uniform, but I don't want it. I don't need pink. Of course, it's not good to neglect your elders, but old folk like me should also know when it's time to step out of the spotlight. Alright, fair enough, Opal. You received a TM from Leader Opal, yes? Your next gym awaits you in Sirchester. Let's see if I can buy Ultra Balls, thank you. Because I'll clearly be needing these. Let's see. Hold on now. Hi, Opal. Yes, Opal? What is it? I've got a few errands to run in Hammerlock. Care to join me for the journey? If you're headed for the next gym stadium, you'll need to get to Hammerlock too, after all. With pleasure. They say two's company, after all. Hooray, we jump straight to Hammerlock. Hammerlock, always such a dusty town, though I suppose some Pokemon prefer it that way. So So I'm actually going to fly back to Stowon side because I want to try and sell an item there and also see what's for sale. Oh, nope, not Route 6. Not Route 6. No. I wanted to go to Stowon side. Oh yeah, I suppose I'm ahead of you now in the story, aren't I, zombie? Let's see, they're already fully healed. What's today's bargain? Metronome. Sure, we'll take that. Nope, don't need anything else. Buying a comet shard for 30,000. I don't have a comet shard, apparently. Alright, Hammerlock. Hey, I see Bead. Yeah, you definitely got time if you got that many days off. I got Monday and Tuesday off. I know for sure. I think I have one other day off. Actually, my schedule's on my phone. I can just check that. Yep, I got Monday, Tuesday, and Saturday off. Nice days. I get the holiday off. And the next day, and I get Saturday off. Most likely I'll also be getting Sunday off as well, because my work, for the full-timers, they give us alternating weekends off, and I'm working this weekend, obviously. Come to gawk at me now that I've had my challenge ban taken away and my gym challenger status revoked. Can you really afford to waste time like this? Not really. I commend your humility. It is appropriate for a trainer of your limited talents. I'll have you know, though, that I haven't given up. I must become the champion in order to help out the chairman. I will go and ask him to let me rejoin the gym challenge. That boy. So you asked for days off before the whole pandemic stuff started, huh? And now that they're... Are they still going, or have all those flights and stuff been canceled? That boy. Now that's what I would call pink. So sincere and straightforward, and yet so twisted and misguided. I like it. It's the kind of thing that gives people some depth. Time for my gym mission, child. What? Pink. Congratulations, child. Oh, God. Opal, what are you doing? Miss Opal, what in the world has gotten into you? You were used by Alina, am I right? You worked hard to gather the wishing stars for her, only to have her throw you away like rubbish once she was done with you. Come with me, child. I might be able to help you out. Of course, it all depends on how much hard work you're willing to put in, too. Are you testing me? Very well, I accept. In fact, I plan on making sure you see my full talents and tell me everything you know about the wishing stars. Farewell for now, child. You should head to Sir Chester. I take it you know how to get to Route 7? Well, that's unfortunate that they can't go on their trip now. But I suppose it's good for you that now that you'll have company for that. Nope. Get back in there before I forget again. We need to remember some moves. Let's see, Sun Tanner can learn Thunderbolts. Yeah, it is becoming hurricane season. Actually, I'll probably keep Parabolic Charge. Well. Yeah, he doesn't learn too much else, does he? So yeah, Parabolic Charge. And we'll leave that for now. Time to see what Bipolar can learn. Moonblast, that is definitely something I'm interested in. We'll get rid of Dazzling Gleam because I don't need that. Alright, and can it learn Psychic right now? No, it cannot. So I guess that's it for Bipolar. Now let's see about Rockstar. It can learn Cross Chop, that would actually be decent. But do I want to get rid of Seed Bomb for it? I think if I get rid of Seed Bomb, I'm lacking a lot of coverage. So I think we'll keep Seed Bomb. Alright, and then Extinction. And nothing there to learn. Alright. So then, now that Rockstar is fully evolved, that means it can make good use of the move we picked up earlier for a while back, Facade. The reason that Facade works so well with Rockstar is because of Rockstar's ability, which is Guts. So, if Rockstar is hit with a status condition, its attack stat goes up by 1.5% by a 1.5 multiplier. And if Facade is used while the Pokemon is afflicted with a status condition, the move's power is doubled. So suddenly you got something with 1.5 times attack and hitting with 140 move. It hurts a lot. Let's see, I'm pretty sure I picked up Hyper Voice somewhere. Yep. So we'll teach that to Sun Tanner. Alright, so Sun Tanner's, I wonder if Sun Tanner can learn anything else that's useful. Something else that can be used for coverage. Nope. Alright. Then we'll teach Energy Ball to Bipolar. Energy Ball is just a better version of Magical Leaf, minus the auto hit. But really, we don't need auto hit. then I guess we'll teach suntan or grass knot. Instead of that parabolic charge. So that he has some sort of coverage moves. And I think that'll be it for all those. Hey, Sonia. Hey, yeah, the badge collecting going well? I've been doing some research on the ruins in Stoan side, the sword and shield. What kind of Pokemon were they? And where are they now? I still have so many questions. I was thinking about taking another look at the tapestries in... Kaboom! Oh, dear. Are you kidding me? What was that? Hammerlock Stadium shook. That's where Chairman Rose's power plant, isn't it? Huh? A power spot? You mean like where you can Dynamax? That's right, the power spot detector reacts when it's possible to Dynamax. Hey, Sonia, and Belvedere too, you felt the shaking, right? Seems Chairman Rose is testing something again. This is bad. Pokemon might start Dynamaxing right in the middle of Hammerlock. Is that so? I can make sure the chairman knows. You'll just get lost, Leon. I'm going too. I'm really looking forward to seeing you compete in the finals, so you should leave the investigation of the quaking to the adults. Head to Sir Chester and get that gym badge. Hey, look, it's Hop. Oh, Belvedere. First that forest, then that mad quiz. I've been lost in every sense of the word. But it looks like I finally caught up to you again. Come with me to Route 7. I could use a bit of competition to motivate me. Well, you heard it here, folks. You heard it here first, folks. We're actually ahead of our rival for once. But he also wants to fight, as per usual. Let's see, is there any useful TMs from this spot? Not any that I would consider to be useful for my team. So instead of buying TMs, I'm actually going to sell all of the stuff that I don't need. And probably deck out my character a bit. Let's see. Oh, I got quite a few candies actually. Let's see here. Where's all of my sellable stuff? Oh, wait, that's right. There's an actual treasure section. I forgot about that. That's very handy that they did that. Separated the bag into even more categories. I could also sell my fossils if I wanted to, just because I don't plan on using them. Well, that's a decent amount of money. So I think we'll head back to the clothing shop and see if we can't fix how our character looks. I actually don't mind how she looks right now, but I only did all the fire stuff for the TM acrobatics. So first, we'll go and get our hair cut again. And I think we'll go with that. We're going to get our hair cut, and surprisingly, it gets longer. Alright, so now we got a new hairstyle. Let's go for new clothing, too. And hopefully a bag that I actually like. Let's take off the jacket, because I'm not very likely to wear that. We'll grab that in case I feel like wearing a jacket. Let's see, I actually like some of these skirts. I think the white one looks best though. Let's see, no dresses. No shoes. Alright, what about the backpack? And I don't like any of those hats. Do we have any regular glasses? Nope. So I guess we'll call that good for there, and go rearrange our clothes a bit. Let's see here. I really don't like the gloves. Yeah, no gloves. So I think we'll go with this design for a while. We do have, what? I think there's two more clothing shops that we have left in this game. Anyways, let's go and put Hop back in his place again. Because we all know that our rival always needs that. Alright, Hop, I'm coming for you. Alright, Belvedere, you and I both know I've got to keep trying different strategies if I'm gonna get strong enough to catch up to Lee. No, not just catch up, if I want to surpass him. So I think you know what's coming, mates. Let me try out my latest in a battle against you. Alright, Hop, let's see what you got this time. Trevenant, oh boy. Alright, time for me to test exactly how far I can go with my latest. So, we're gonna volt switch out of this. Just because, Suntanner doesn't have any great way of hitting that thing. And instead, we'll put Rockstar in. Confuse Ray? Oh, crap. Confuse Ray is not what I wanted to see, thank you. Oh well, one night slash should be enough to take care of this. Well, there went the poor Trevenant. The way you battle, you know, it kind of reminds me of Lee. Shut up, Hop, I don't care. I only battle how I want to, Hop. No more, no less. Ooh, now we got Heatmore coming out. Do I have a switch in for Heatmore? I don't think I do. At least, not generally for fire types. So, I guess we'll go with Facade. If Rockstar doesn't hit itself. Oh boy. Yeah, that's right, Heatmore. Eat that. And now have a nice Night Slash as well. Oop, we got another Fire Lash. Alright, better do a hard switch though, just in case he hits himself. Okay. Let's go, Luchador. Oh, Hop used a Hyper Potion. How nice. Time to use Luchador's favorite move, Dig. I'm sorry, what were you trying to hit? Well, whatever it is, just came out of the ground and hit ya. That was a crit. Ow. Consider it the possibility your opponent might land a critical hit on a Pokemon, right? Yeah, Hop, no, I don't need memories of critical hits KOing things. Get out of here with that crap. Surprise KOs from crits are an easy way for me to get a Pokemon to faint in this playthrough. Uh-oh, we got Bolton now. I really don't want to do a hard switch, but I'd also rather not risk this thing actually hitting. So let's go, Sun Tanner. Spark. Oh lord, that hurt. Let's use Hyper Voice. Well. Oh, Roar. Who's coming out now? Oh, come on! Luchador does not need to stay out here. Oh, fine then. Let's U-turn and see what happens. Alright, Sun Tanner, you're still up. Because I think all he has left is his Drizzile. Oh, nope, he has Snorlax. Okay, yeah, no, you're not staying in against this, Sun Tanner. Let's get you out of there. And put you. I don't know if I actually have much of anything I want to put in. Let's do Extinction, I guess. Stockpile. Oh, you piece of crap. You're not stockpiling anything. Get out of here. Yep, Heavy Slam. Oh god. Hooray for Parish Body. Because that's exactly what I needed to see. Let's lower that attack stat while you're still here, though. I and give me all of that health. Alright. One more strength zap so that we're up all the way to full health, hopefully. Alright, and this is the last turn before both of these guys faint. So we're gonna have to do a hard switch. And we're gonna do that into Suntanner. Because Suntanner resists steel type moves at least. Goodbye, Snorlax. And Luchador wants to learn Swords Dance. I think Swords Dance is actually more useful than Roost is for him. And Extinction's level 41. I'm the kind of guy who gets fired up to win in these situations. Oh, we got Inteleon, folks. Okay, so Volt Switch out. Oh, nope, it's using Tearful Look. Doesn't want me getting off much damage. That still hurt it a lot. Hi, Inteleon. I think you remember Skylar, right? You know, the thing that froze you last time? Well, it's here to do it again. Alright, we beat Hop again. This is rubbish. My team can't perform if I can't get my own head straight as their trainer. Before we ever started out on this journey, I remember watching Lee on the telly. He was like a bright star, so strong I could hardly bear to look right at him. But now I can tell you just how strong he really is, and what he's got that I haven't. But I'm getting stronger too. Maybe not as fast as you, but fine, whatever. Thanks for letting me battle with you again, and here, I'll heal up your team for you too. Thanks, because I was just about to head over to the Pokemon Center to do that. I think I know what it is I really want. I want to battle Lee. I want to take on my bro. But not just that, I want to beat him. I want to be the one who beats the unbeatable champion, and I'm going to. My mind's made up. You and me are going to have another battle once I get the gym badge in Surchester. Alright, Hop. Sounds like you're at least far more certain about what you're doing at this point. Alright, and I think we're gonna call that for today's episode.